So if I want to make some bead molding like this, I can do that with a roundover bit from a cheap router bit set and my tilting router lift, and just tilting it on there like that. The only problem is this guide bearing really gets in the way. So I can remove that guide bearing just with the Allen key that came with the set. Some of them are really stuck on there, so first taking out this screw, and the bearing comes off. But there's still this post on here, and that post still gets in the way. I can remove that post by carefully grinding it off on the bench grinder. So the important thing when flattening the top of a router bit is that this area here is lower than what's left of the carbides. It's okay to nick the inside edges of the carbide a little bit, but the important part is that the outside corner is still good, and that the area between them from here to here is lower than the carbides. Otherwise you'll get burning on the top, and that's no good. Now I've had a problem with this bevel bit here. When I ground off the guide post, I found that the top edge here really wasn't the right shape, and it caused some burn marks, so I had to actually relief cut the carbide back a little bit. And the bench grinder doesn't really work very well with that. I found a diamond tip tile saw was able to cut the carbide, but not very cleanly. So it made a bit of a mess of it, but it was good enough to make a relief cut, and now this bit doesn't burn anymore. So modifying router bits like that is maybe a little bit risky, but this router bit set came with the router that I bought. It only added about $20 to the price, and I have two sets like that, so if I screw up one of the bits, I'm only wasting a dollar.